Okay, so we're off to, was it Pavilion 6? Pavilion 6? Yeah, Pavilion 6 to get the synchronizer because we think that Ida's voice box is broken. I don't think that's the problem at all. I think she's maybe when she connected to the web to check her version, something happened and she's contracted like a virus or, you know, some sort of thing that breaks down the fake copy, because although she is the real copy, or she says she is, there's another version that exists of her, so she's technically illegal because she's been offline, so that makes her the copy now. So maybe she has, when she connected, downloaded something into her personality or subroutine or whatever that is just gonna completely pick her apart. I don't really know. This whole thing's very weird, though, isn't it? With the whole amusement park that's actually a hospital. It's very weird. It's still pretty snazzy, though. I'll give it that. I don't know where the black blobs are. I'm not too worried. I'm just keeping an eye out. Also, that thing that's on the stage is still, like, a worry to me. What if it eventually wakes up and I have to fight it? Right, 6th. 8? 6th. This is number 6. Right, so we're going to go up here and do a puzzle. Oh, shit. Okay. The elevator's out of order. Good. How do we get up there then? What the fuck's going on? What the fuck was that? Why did it go dark? Like, genuinely, what the fuck was that? That bubble's still there as well. Like, can you see? This has generated a bubble around it, and these are a bit bugged. Like, some of the plants have gone a bit weird. I'm not quite sure what's going on there. Also, that darkness freaked me the fuck out. Especially because it's near him. So how do I get up to number 6? Oh.
I figured out what kind of breakdown the report was referring to. During a transfer, the ability to speak was not blocked out for one of the kids. That is, he was talking to himself, to his own copy.
Oh. Right. Oh, that's a bit worrying. So this is completely broken. How do I get up to number 6? I'm going to try and go up to this one. And then see if I can get across to 6. I'm not entirely sure it'll work. But I can't see any other way of getting up there. That darkness as well is worrying me, which is making me really want to... It might have been a bug, but I'm not taking the risk here. What the devil? Oh, hang on. Can I... Oh god, really? This might be it. This might be how we do this. Oh god, I think it is. This is not nice. Oh, fuck's sake. Okay. God, that was horrible. Is this number 6? Oh god, look at what a mess it is. This is number 6, so I'm just gonna do that and then I guess go this way. Oh no. Okay. Huh. Oh fuck. Like, drop down to here. And then and then to here. And then oh, can I? Yes. Although I'm just gonna just gonna do that. Ooh, fuck. This is not what I wanted in my day. Oh, no, hang on. If I can get onto this. Ugh. Jesus Christ. Huh. Oh, God. Huh. Okay. Whew. We're here. Jesus Christ, I did not want to do that.
I see you. Go on in.
Thank you. Let me in, please. I don't really like it up here. That thing up there in the middle's a bit weird as well. Right, let's see what's going on in this one. I now get why it's a padded cell with squares. Like, if it's to do with the kids having more phobia, the fear of shapes. But it did also, do you remember I said it reminded me very much of like a psychiatric hospital, sort of the padded walls thing? That, I guess, would go into that as well a little bit, maybe. It definitely came across as treatment centre, didn't it? Like, there's certain bits you look at and you're like, I can see what that could be. Right, okay, I've got the synchroniser. Oh, God. The game is... There we go. Sorry, I just got to give it a moment. Right, let's go. Can we go down here? Oh, yes, we can. Has it gone darker? Whoa. Sorry about the frame rate. Once again, there's a few optimization issues with the game. And like missing textures every now and then. But I think in the grand scheme of things, considering, this game's pretty funky.
I know why there was so little information about me. August 15th was my first work day at the Gerbera Garden. I had come here for the first time with that group of kids, and the explosion occurred 2 hours later.
Did you do it? Are you responsible? I mean, obviously it was your group of kids, but what went down? I guess we'll find out. Yeah, no, it is getting... Oh, the moon! Yeah, it's... Oh, look at that! Look at that. Look! It's actually a shooting star. That's really nice detail. Awesome. So yeah, the day has gone on. It is now becoming evening. The sun is setting over there, I guess, and then the moon is here. There's a nice moon. So I like this time of day in this game. To be fair, they all look pretty snazzy, but this one does really suit it. These colours work really nicely. That bird is having a slight issue there, but I think he's okay. Just doing a bit of a rubber band. I like the trees as well. I like how they've done the leaves without branches. Like, it's a very simple concept to do, but it kind of works, because sometimes if you add too many branches to trees in a game... Oh, God. Steady. Sorry, it's loading all the shit in the yurt in again, so it's having a small crisis. But yeah, no, I like it because it gives a very clean art style. It's the suggestion of branches, which means that it's not overly cluttered as a model. God, something's not going on well here. I think it's calming down though. Hi, I've got your thing.
I did. Hold on while I replace it.
Your eyes are going weird again as well. I don't think this is going to fix you. I'll try to fix you. Oh, God. Let's see. This one? Oh, God, there we go. Oh, God, she's having a fit again. That's not a good sign, surely. You alright?
Well?
It's fine.
Thoughts still messed up?
No. Everything's fine.
Oh.
Then it helped.
For now. We'll see if it lasts.
Yes.
How long will your charge last?
About 2 weeks, maybe less. Say, know what I found? the correspondence of that operator, Mark, with one of his colleagues. There are some strange tidbits here. Here, listen to this.
So we were going to say, to be honest, it doesn't really interest me, but it kind of interests me, because I'm like, well, something's obviously going down.
To be honest, it doesn't really interest me.
Wait, this is important. It's about your parents.
Oh.
What?
Your parents. And me as well. Here, listen. It's a work correspondence. They're talking about research into memory transfer between people using telepathy.
Telepathy.
Telepathy?
That's what it says here. They're discussing telepathy and also mention some kind of side effect. They refer to it as MPR Zero. The MPR Zero effect.
What is it?
What is it?
Well, if my understanding is correct, it's a sensation. A strange sensation experienced when one transmits one's memory.
Right.
And what of it?
Mark writes that at one time he was very interested in the matter, studying MPR Zero thoroughly after that incident with Ida.
Right, so what... Okay, have you... Well, I guess we'll find out if she's got any information for us.
That incident?
We must have been acquainted. Even though I remember nothing about Mark or any unusual effects, and I cannot imagine what incident he's referring to.
And what about my parents?
That's here, too. He recalls working at a research station before the garden was constructed. There weren't many people around in those days. His circle of contacts was limited to several work colleagues and his Mongolian friends. He writes, "It's the family living in a yurt not far from the landing platform." That's your family, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sounds like it.
Where are your parents now?
They died long ago. Why?
They could have probably answered many of our questions. Maybe Mark even told them about me.
Yeah, oh, she's going again.
Are you all right?
Yes, maybe. Maybe he told them.
Yeah, you're going again.
Ida, is everything fine?
Everything fine is an ordinary word. Just a note. Like the weather, chilly or warm, but we were looking for other research. Family records, kind letters, so... What was that just now? More of the same?
Yep.
Yes. Again.
Enibish.
Yeah, I think your thing's breaking down.
What?
I don't think I have much time. Please, help me untangle this web with Mark. I want you to look through your parents' things. They may have left behind notes, journals.
Okay.
Understood. I'll go look for them.
Oh.
Tabaha is here.
He might know. He knew our parents. My parents, not our parents. Let's go see. Tabaha! What the shit's going down with our parents? Yeah, to be fair, he knew about the place, yet he didn't mention that my parents were involved, so... A little bit of screen tearing there as well. I want to know what's going on. Tabaha! Where's the entrance? It's like around here, isn't it? Yeah. Hi! You having a snooze?
Looks like it'll rain.
Rain? Today?
There'll be rain and thunder, and it'll sweep all profiteers into a ditch.
That sounds bad.
What happened?
You got any idea how much the search cost me?
No. How much?
1.5.
Oh.
Is that a lot?
Well, when in Bayanhangor has the internet ever cost 1.5?
I don't know.
I'll pay you back.
I won't take money from your destitute self.
Okay, thanks.
All right. Thanks.
The information was paid for and delivered by a personal courier.
Very nice. So, what did you find out?
Well, first of all, the Gebera Garden was never about entertainment.
Yeah, we know that.
It was a hospital, I know. But what happened to it?
The kids were all patients, yeah? Well, one of them had his container overflow. The passim exploded. That's what happened.
Really? Okay. Sounds...
That's all?
Hold your horses. The story ain't so simple. Think. A person gets his body replaced and blows up minutes later. You might ask, how could they not have checked the container? Turns out they did check, and the container was empty. And yet, 15 minutes later, it up and explodes. In other words, the capsule filled and overflowed rapidly, pretty much instantly in point of fact.
Was that due to the fact that it was the kids and the negative emotions of bodies or something? It just made all this passium happen really quickly? I don't know.
There must have been a reason.
Must have been, sure. But it wasn't found. All that's known is that there was a mishap with this particular child's transfer. Turns out, he had been talking to himself while in the booth. That was the mishap. As to why he blew up, that part's unclear. When he came outside, all his stats were normal. And he looked calm. You can see it on the video.
Oh, so we've got a video. And it's the kid that Ida said, I've been talking.
What's the video you mentioned?
From the security cameras. You can see everything. Here he is, coming out of the booth in an M-body. Here's the sword acceptance ceremony. Here he is, getting off the stage and heading into the garden. He's walking evenly, takes a seat on the edge of a flower bed, then this part is a bit unclear.
Okay.
What's happening?
A child comes up to him as he's sitting. A teeny little thing. Walks up and says something to him. Looks like the kid fancies the sword and is asking for it.
What sword?
What sword?
A toy. Just a shiny toy sword. They were given to the kids as presents after their body replacements. Endure a transfer, get a toy.
Okay.
Okay. So our hero hands over the sword. He's holding on to the hilt, hand extended. The child is trying to take the sword but can't.
Why not?
Why can't he?
Because he's grabbing at the blade, which is holographic. The kiddo's fingers swish right through the air, through the illusion.
Okay, so what happens then?
I see. And then what happens?
Then, nothing happens. It's the end of the recording. The explosion is coming up. Here's a grown-up approaching the kids. That's the transfer operator. He walks up to his patient and asks him something. The latter turns around and blows up a second later. And that's it. Doesn't clear up much, I'm afraid.
Annoying.
What was his name?
Mark. Or who are you asking about? The one who blew up? That was Alber.
I haven't heard of Alber before.
And the other child?
The little one? Don't know. He was one of the locals. Not sure how he ended up inside the garden.
Is it me?
Have fun with your little mystery now, but I'm off.
Okay, then.
See you tomorrow?
I don't know. It might be 3-4 days, maybe a week. We'll see. All right, take care now. Don't get caught in the rain.
Hold on, Tabaha. I've got one more question.
I told you everything I know about this garden. I got nothing else.
No, it's not about the garden.
It's not about the garden. It's about my parents. I wanted to remember something about my parents.
Here.
Oh.
What's this?
A key to the drawer of your Grandpa Bachin's bedside table.
Oh, sweet.
Where did you get it?
Bachin left it to me. He said that if ever you asked me about your parents, to give you this key. So, that's what I'm doing. And I don't know nothing else. Goodbye.
Oh, okay. Thanks, dude.
Goodbye, Tabaha.
Finally, get in that goddamn drawer. I've been wanting to get into for bloody ages. Can't get in the chest, but I can get in the drawer. So we'll see what's in the drawer. Hopefully there's some answers in there. That looks like a spider. It's not, though. Thank God. Oh. Stuck on a stone. Eee. Don't we need to change Ungots before nighttime? Isn't that a thing? I don't know. There we go. Oh! Flashlight attachment. Grandpa Badger's journal. On the inside are several brief notes. Two pages split by a bookmarker dense with text. It's a message for Enibis. I'll read everything. So this is in 58. It says, well, now the home of my son is empty, so fate has decided. I'm not complaining either. Providence knows what's best. All that's left for me is to pray for them. I'll head out in the morning. It's over 200 miles. I best not forget a gas canister. It'll be dark when I get there. The wake will go on all night, and come morning, I'll be gone, leaving everything as it is. So that's the parents dying, and this is the grandfather speaking. Then it says, Providence has got a plan, to be sure, in which my role is a modest one. As for the baby, of course I'll take care of him. I'll take him with me to Ulaanbaatar. I'm not so easily scared. And then, no use guessing now. These parts won't let him go, no doubt about it. Evidently, we're destined to live here. What other option is there? Only abandoning him, and that I will not do. So, something happened over those 2 days. I remember there was a thing about blacking out and stuff, so maybe there was something about you remove the kid and the kid was blacking. I don't know. That's just... It might not be at all. He won't drink milk, he won't eat anything. What do I feed him? He's growing so fast. Isn't it early for a 2-week-old child to walk on his own 2 feet? And where did he go at night? What the fuck? I can't figure out what it is he found. Some kind of device. 3 days now he's been playing with it, dragging it through the dust, gnawing at it. I suppose he's teething. And then he stopped growing. This is less than a month since the diary started, I think. Or just around a month. He stopped growing, hasn't changed in a week. A 5-year-old child is walking around the yurt. Keep walking, son. Your appearance doesn't scare me. But how is it that you look so much like him? I guess that's not for me to know. Providence has got a plan, in which my role is a modest one. My job is to pray. Okay. An air shuttle flew by yesterday. So this is like years in the future. Like 10, was it 10 years? Hang on. Oh, not 10 years, like 4 years, 5 years. An air shuttle flew by today. It's been a long time since we've seen one. I couldn't make any people inside. Couldn't make out any people inside. Could it be it's used as freight? And then it says, what a meeting. Like a year later. What a meeting. Praise Providence, you reckless soul. If it wasn't for Enibish, that's us, you, Tabahar, would be lying in that flower bed. So what did Enibish do? But it's a solid money-making idea. The passage is free, which is always good. The tires on the scooter won't need replacing. I'm going to sell it. And now we've just got the letter left. Enibish, if you're reading this letter, that means your curiosity has led you into the past to your forebears. Your parents' belongings are locked away in chests. I will give you the key with which to open them. But know this, no things will give you any answers until you've asked yourself the right question. Of all the possible paths, only one will lead you to this question. Find the one true path. Find this one true path, and may my modest assistance ease your search. You will need a ray of phantom light to illuminate your path and a wise clue to make the right decision at a crossroads. Okay. In this drawer lies a rounded object. Use it to obtain the ray of light. So that was the torch attachment. In a book of wisdom, you'll find a clue. I wonder if that's the Tibetan Book of the Dead. Then go to my grave, stand on the largest stone, and take a look around using the ray of light. Look carefully and you'll see a spot from which to begin your path. Okay, so I need the torch. The torch is over here. Go away. Go away. Right, so that's that. Got the torch attachment. Then we need a book. Read the parable from the book under the altar, so it is the Tibetan Book of the Dead it wants. Pure white flame burns so brightly, so blindingly that it pains the eyes to behold it. Pure white flame. So again, another jump forwards. Sorry, guys, it's just how the game works in terms of trying to make it as compact as possible for watching. But you get to the grave and you see this stuff if you use the torch. And what you have to do is you have to take the sun route, followed by the moon route, followed by the sun route, etc., etc., until you get to a point at which certain things are going on, and you find a specific item, which I'll show you in a minute. Now, there's so much speculation about the ending that's coming up, so you're very welcome to speculate in the comments, but there's also a lot of confusion. So what I will also do is, at the end, I will quickly try and summarise from the Steam forum, where there is a thread dedicated to this, what people think has happened. And you could judge for yourself whether that's happened or not. I miss a few of the pages that apparently would help with this specific ending and making me aware of what's going on, but certain other people on the forums have read it and gone, I'm none the wiser, I don't think that helped me. But we'll go through all of that at the end of the game. For now, I'm trying to find this question, which hopefully leads me through to an answer that is supposed to explain the entire plot. And then to the moon. And then, who am I? Who am I? Oh. It's this thing that I found, like, ages ago. This. Here you'll find the answer to your question. Who am... Of course! I looked at it before and it was like, don't know the question. Who am I? Oh shit, look. That's right, Enabish. Who am I is the question that leads to the secret of your past. You are but a step away from unravelling the mystery. From the ancient mystifying events whose meaning I never did grasp till the end of my days. Perhaps only you are destined to reveal their divine plan. I promised you a key to the chests that store your parents' belongings. This key is before you. With it, I pass you that which I have guarded in my memory for many years. Yes, the things in the chest belong to Dzamble and Sane. However, these people are not your parents or even your relatives. They had a son of their own once, but he died in the explosion under the dome. He was 5 years old and his name was Shagatai. Several days after the explosion, a golden eagle arrived here, carrying a human infant. He set the child down on the ground in front of the yurt. You were that infant, Enabish. Who you are and where you came from, I don't know. From that day, the home of my late son became a haven for you and Ongut. I was not repulsed by the strange appearance of your bodies. Sorry. Who am I to pass judgment on Providence? Dismay came a month later when Chagatai's features on your face became unmistakable. Goodbye forever, your grandfather, Bajin. So if Enabish wasn't the original child, but looks very much like him, does that mean that both of them are clones of someone else? Perhaps Mark? Because we share a thing with Ida, and he shared a thing with Ida? I completely forgot. I found that thing before, and it was like, you don't have the question to answer this. It was like, oh. But I think we would have had to have found who am I anyway. But cool. Right, let's open this fucking chest and see what's in it. It's very heavy. Okay, what we got? We've got... Oh, what is that? What is that? It's a... Oh, it's a saddle. Right, we'll pop it in this corner. Because... Yes. The Top Secret History of Everything magazine. Look, we don't need that either. Let's pop that down there. We probably don't need that one either. Oh, Jesus. Here you go. Right. Do we need this? No. Oh, what's this? Oh, and a radio. Jesus Christ, guys. That's a lot of shit. Now I can move the chest. Pop the chest down. There. And then, oh, hello, steady. Ah! Stuff! Got this? What is that? Dunno, no need for it. Do I need this? Looks like a typewriter. Don't need that. What's this? Oh, there's some shit underneath it. Don't need that. Packs of letters. One correspondence mentions Mark and Ida. I've already written you about him. He works nearby at the station. Well, a few years back, he'd met a girl. He says they saw each other only once in the company of friends, and somehow the way she looked at him, he's been dreaming of that moment ever since. Mark speaks of some strange sensation called the Babylonian effect, and that the entire institute is studying it at present. Zambul and I laugh in return. The sensation is totally normal, Mark. We've studied it thoroughly long ago. Kiko slides to the curb and go to Ida before she gets her body replaced. This is one of the things that the Steam forums picked up on and theorised that perhaps because of the Babylonian effect and Ida and Mark being linked, that would be why Enobish is perhaps a clone of Mark, because he is showing signs of similar stuff, and also perhaps why the grandson then is a clone, because obviously he's identical to Enobish and a young Mark. But again, it's all very speculative, so who the fuck knows?
I found it. You and Mark had met once before.
Yes, I already know. I remembered it.
Mark was recalling some kind of special moment.
Nothing so special that it stayed with me. Except maybe there was this strange sensation.
Mm-hmm.
A sensation?
Yes. Sometimes I get a peculiar feeling. It somehow resembles anxiety, but only partially. I can't really describe it. It is a sad, pleasant feeling.
Right.
I had felt it again that particular evening, and...
And what?
Enobish, I'm about to shut down.
No!
Wait. We're not done figuring out your past.
And we won't. I am out of time. I received a message.
From whom?
From my neurochip. Only, the neurochip writes in red letters. I'm being informed that it is self-destructing.
What? No.
Know what I can do?
What?
Split myself in two.
Sorry?
What do you mean?
When I shut down, my upper half will split from my legs.
Right.
Why?
I've no clue. That's just how my body works. I can show you. Watch.
No, oh, God.
Wait, don't. Ida, listen.
I'm listening.
Maybe there's still a way to fix everything.
Fix everything? Well, there is a way. If you can travel to the past and pass 4 digits to Professor Koch, that would fix everything.
How am I traveling to the past? Am I communicating with myself in the past, or am I communicating with you via the Babylonian effect? I don't know, Ida. What do you want from me? Oh, no. Her number's gone out. Oh, God. What the fuck? Oh God, the rain! Everything's gone wrong. Ida? Let me take your hair from you. And, oh God, Ida, can we put you back in? Oh my God, she's completely fucked. Ida! Why? I didn't mean to drop you, I'm just... Jesus. Now what? Take Ida to a powerful source of electricity? Oh God, okay. Right. Ida? We'll just have to go to the dome. And hope we can do something there. In a vertical position at the centre of the ruined flower bed. Oh, hey buddy. What are you doing here? Which sparking cable? Oh, Jesus Christ, that one. Okay, cool. It's not very clear, partly because the flowers are completely fucked. And also that thing's coming. But this is apparently the ruined flower bed. So if we put her there, then we pick the cable up. I've removed the lid from her back. Fine, there. Pick up. Oh my God, fucking hell. Actually, this is like ridiculous. Where's it gone now? There it is. Jesus Christ, stop jumping. Let me pick you up. Right. There. Whew, bloody hell. Right, come on, electricity. Come on. Yeah, it's probably not good I just stand quite so close. Did that work? Hello?
Are you there? Ida.
I'm here.
Oh, cool.
How do you feel?
Strange.
I'd feel pretty strange if I woke up again here.
Strange? In what way? Describe your state.
I feel anxious.
That's good.
It's not that good.
Yes. Just don't shut down. Look at me.
Why?
I'll explain everything later.
Will you? What if she doesn't survive that long? Oh shit. That's some badass lightning. We're now supposed to have inferred from all the stuff that's around, so like the sphere, and this what the game does is it now highlights texts around the yurt that would help explain the situation. As I said before, Steam forums, take it or leave it, they said on the documents. It didn't really help in some cases. But what we are supposed to have inferred from that is that the lightning strikes have somehow sent us back in time into the original Mark, in order to communicate the four digits that will save the world. It's a bit of a weird one. Once you see it, you're like, yeah, I get the story, but sometimes it's a little bit hard to see that, and it feels like it almost is a bit too obscure.
You said that it's this place for you and me.
We save the world by going back in time and being Mark and doing all this weird stuff. Yes, again, there's no actual confirmation. I don't think that that is the ending, but that's what everyone seems to have come to as a conclusion. So I hope that sort of makes sense. And maybe if you want to see more of it and, you know, read more documents, you can always buy the game and play it yourself. By the time this video comes out, the optimization may have been fixed. But I have enjoyed playing it. It's very different. I think it was worth the wait as well. And I hope you guys have enjoyed it too, despite the sort of cuts that I've had to put in to make it a little bit more watchable. But yeah, if you enjoy the game, please do go and check it out on Steam. It's in the video description below. And I'll see you guys next time for more gaming content. Thanks very much for watching. See you soon. Bye!